Progressive overload must take place, but that doesn't always have to be through increasing weight. In today's video, I'll explain very simple methods of objectively getting really strong, as in using the same weights for weeks or even months at a time and yielding tangible gains. So, let me first say that proximity to failure is a huge gauge for progression. Like, if you're constantly hitting zero reps in reserve, you know that that was your 100% all-out effort for hypertrophy work. It's the equivalent of doing a one rep max. And so anything that makes that easier is no longer 100%. Therefore, it's objectively superior progress. Here's what I mean. Let's say you're benching 225 for 3 sets of 10. And towards those last few reps, the bar speed slows down. You're a lot less explosive. Maybe technique breaks down ever so slightly, butt comes off the bench. You're straining to the max, making faces, and you just feel dead after a set, while being unable to get an 11th rep, even if you tried. And this goes on for all 3 sets, 0 reps in reserve across the board. In this situation, a lot of people would say, huh, I got 10, 10, 10, therefore I'm going to up the load to 230 next workout. And so you may be down to reps of 8 at this point. So you're still in the 6 to 10 zone, but now the reps have been cut back substantially and you gotta rebuild back up. This works, but the alternative solution is to recognize that, yes, you achieved your sets and reps, but it could be easier with the same weight. So what I'm gonna recommend right now is being extremely patient with the weights used. Don't rush for the next PR, cruise around to the point where those reps in reserve start to increase. I think it's an excellent goal to get 2 reps in reserve for every single set. So your starting point might be extremely fatiguing, you're dead, you're resting 5 minutes between sets because you pretty much have no choice. You go from having the most intense, brutal sets to, hey, this is pretty freaking easy. And once that happens, instead of increasing the weight once more, now you can modify technique. Which in the case of bench press, that could be switching over to the close grip. And because it's no longer absolute failure, you'll still be in the 6 to 10 zone. So maybe now you're getting 7-7-7 or 7-6-6. You can rebuild back up, which takes time. This is an anti-plateau mindset because you really are embracing slow progression. This is what it means to milk the weights for a long period of time. And eventually, you end up right back at 3x10. Then those 10s get easier as they're no longer 0 reps in reserve. And what happens after going through all this long progression? You can throw in one more element if you so choose to, the pause, if it wasn't already there. So what's essentially happened is you mastered 2 plates. No matter what conditions you're put under, it's not difficult anymore. And so when you go back to the regular variation that started it all, guess what? You can really rep things out. Maybe now it's 5 reps in reserve for every set. So what's the consequence of that? You gotta increase the weight by 20 to 30 pounds. And that's not unrealistic if I'm being honest with you. And by the way, I referenced the bench press because it's one of my favorite lifts, and don't we all love it as gym bros? But this also applies to lower body and pretty much universally across every lift. Like, if you're doing squats for quads, that requires a different technique to which the knees come forward first instead of hinging backwards, and the torso remains more upright. If you start seeing yourself doing good morning squats, but now you're still completing the desired sets and reps, well, obviously, you're taking away from the muscle biasing. So, in many cases, you sticking to that same load to refine technique is what's gonna make your quads bigger and stronger. And then, once you're able to do what I described previously, where the reps in reserve is no longer 0, you can further maximize that technique by doing heel elevated squats, as well as pausing at the bottom with the knee shifted forward, which gives a crazy sensation in the quads. They become the limiting factor. And so, it's not always about getting stronger at the movement. On paper, it might say barbell back squat 3 sets of 10 with a check mark. But if you're not factoring in the intensity that went into those sets, as well as the technique modification, then how much progression were you leaving out within those parameters. Makes sense? Now I want to talk about changing the implement itself so that we're still doing the same exercise, but it's a variety that allows us to get more or less weight through leverage manipulation. For the bench press, that could be switching over from the straight bar to the Swiss. And in most cases, there will be a ratio that's predetermined based upon muscular weaknesses and your individual build. In my case, there is always a 35-pound difference between the two lifts. And so if I did everything that I talked about before on the bench press, 225 for 3x10 being the example, I got way stronger at that. And now I'm at a point where I have to increase the load considerably. Guess what? You don't have to if you switch the Swiss bar. It'll put you directly back to your starting point from 3 months ago. Exact same load, similar percentages, and you can go through the whole progression once more. You see what I'm saying, guys? And what you'll find in this case is your regular straight bar bench will automatically explode. You might come in and hit a minimum of 250 for an easy 3x10, and that's without any specific training. Just a general strength carryover accomplishes that. What about lower body? Use a safety squat bar. I got the Bells of Steel one. Highly recommend you get it as well. Many people report a 15 to 30% weight reduction, and that has to do with the camber. So not only do you have something that's easier on recovery, but the stimulus is still freaking high. Heck, sometimes the implement is so difficult that you can't even hit the bare minimum reps for what you originally plan on doing. You actually have to go backwards. So imagine what happens when you do return to your traditional setup. So maybe on a straight bar, you were hitting 185 on good mornings, but then you switch to SSB and it's down to 155, 30 pounds off. So what do you think is gonna happen when you finally reclaim that plate and a half? Your regular straight bar good morning will be closing in on two plates. And that isn't unrealistic in any type of way. We can talk about technique, but these movements are so similar enough that carryover should be instant. General strength absolutely 100% applies. Guys, all I'm saying is there's so many ways of getting stronger besides, okay, add 5 to 10 pounds and keep inducing linear progression, or try out this periodization strategy. Go through all these waves of percentages and mix up these sets and reps. Try 5x5 1 week, then 3 sets of 8 the next, and then do high sets, low reps. Like, okay, you can do all that stuff, or overly simplify your training to the point where you're only managing reps in reserve and technique modification through muscle biasing and, of course, changing the implement itself. So you're still doing the same exercise, but now it's a harder variation, but you're lifting the same weight. All right, this is a very simple way to monitor your progress. Hope everything was clear. Now I want to know from you guys, what's your experience been with some of these methods as opposed to your traditional approach of just piling on more load? Let's hear it, and I will talk to you all next time.